What's up, peeps? Thanks for joining me. My name is David Warren, and this is Day One Tech. And today, I've got a iPad stand. It's a carbon steel stand. They reached out to me and asked me if I wanted to check it out, and I said, yeah, sure, I'll check it out for my people. A couple of different things about it here. Let's take a look at the box. And you can see here, it's angle adjustment, height adjustment. It's carbon steel, and it's a non-slip base. There's the email address. They're also on Instagram and Facebook. Open this up. Take a look at it here. Okay. Very simple packaging here. So inside. Inside it here, we got this magnetic plate. It's got that adhesive on the back there. And then here's the stand. Stand's got rubber feet, a couple screws. It is kind of tight. All right, so we got our iPad here. This is the iPad M4 Pro 11 inch. This is the case that I use. It's actually a magnetic case, but it doesn't work on there. So I need to attach this ring to the back of it. And what I'll do is I'll wipe this down, make sure there's no grease or anything. And then this will attach right here. And then that's how the iPad attaches. So I'm gonna use my isopropyl alcohol. I'm gonna just use the 91%. That's just to make sure that it evaporates as soon as it doesn't leave any residue or any water. That's what the percentage is for. So I'm gonna wipe this down. Stick the plate to it and take a look at it. But it's straightforward. You know, really don't need too many instructions for this one. Put my thing down. Put a little isopropyl on there. I didn't put too much, but there you go. And I'm just doing that to get all the oils and all the stuff off of it. Okay. Now I'm just going to peel this back. Try to get that as close to center as possible. Okay. And typically with something like this, you want to apply pressure somewhere around 30 seconds. That's what I usually do. You don't need to press real hard. You just need to apply pressure. Okay. And there you go. It's a stand. Man, that, look at, I can do that with one hand and since it's touched. I think I want to bring that. Now, this is one of those things where like OCD kicks in. It's a little off-center. I could unstick it and try it again. Or I could just live with it like this. And see how that base turns. So essentially with my MacBook, I now have a separate screen and I can position it anywhere I want. A lot of times when I'm editing, I might edit on this or edit on my Mac, and I can now use this as a separate screen. Or if I just want to watch videos on the side. So there you go. That is the magnetic stand. Take a look at the back here. So yeah, you can tell I put it off to the center a little bit. So, you know, it works. I can put it back on there, try it again. Yeah, that doesn't come off too easy. Yes. Yeah, that's not coming off. So what I would have probably said is attach it to this, take off the, and then position your iPad, because I position for the vertical, but chances are I will be using this in the horizontal. And it's a little off center. Not that you can really notice it, but that's just one of my little tips right there. Attach it to the magnet, take off the adhesive, and then position your iPad, and then stick it. That probably would have worked out a lot better. But it works. But the stand is nice. It's got good weight. It's a nice minimalist look. And you can spin it around so you can get access to everything. I really do like it. If you got any questions, hit me up in the comments. Thanks for watching this video. Do me a favor, hit that like button and subscribe if you're not already subscribed. And until next video, remember, take care of each other. Peace out, and I will see you all soon.